Hello.
Hello.
Yes, you are live on YouTube. Please mute YouTube.
Can you hear me?
Mute YouTube. Go ahead. What do you want to say to us? Yes, you are live on YouTube. What do you want to say?
What translation is this you're using?
Any translation you wish. Which translation you like? You are a Muslim, right?
Yeah.
All right. What's your name, my friend?
Muhammad.
Muhammad. That's wonderful. I like Muhammad names. Okay. What translation you like to read? This is Yusuf Ali.
Yusuf Ali.
Yeah.
You could use Dr. Zach Noick.
I don't know if they have it here in this website. Choose one. They have it in this website. Which one? I'm showing you in the screen.
Show me on the screen.
Yeah. Which one? There's Ahmad Ali, Ahmad Raza Khan, Arbery, Dri Abadi, Halil,
Shakir.
Shakir. Okay, Shakir. Here we go. This is Shakir. You see it? Okay. Click apply. Here we go. So what do you want to say to us about this?
Proof is Allah speaking.
We changed the translation, so what do you want to say now?
How dare you say but the Allah that he had sons?
And why Allah saying how could he have a son when he has no girlfriend?
Because he is the creator of this universe, he can.
So the one who created the universe, he cannot have a son because he didn't have a girlfriend. So he is not Almighty. Almighty, he can do anything he wish.
Well, he is Almighty.
No, okay. Almighty is somebody. He do anything. Here it says, read carefully.
So how did God make Jesus if he had no wife?
Sorry.
How did God make Jesus if he had no wife?
That's a good question. First of all, who says to you that God he made Jesus? Do you have any reference that says God he made Jesus? Secondly, I'm asking you here, if we go about and talk about Jesus in the Quran, Mary in the Quran, she delivered a child, his name is Isa, but she don't have a husband or a boyfriend. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay, so how the God of Miriam was able to do that with Maryam, but yet the God of Muhammad, he cannot do that to himself. He cannot have a son without having a girlfriend.
How could he have a son when he has no concern, and he himself created everything, and he is know of all things? That's a good question.
Okay. So what do you think? What is the solution now? Because if he is Almighty, you know what we understand, that Almighty God, we call him Almighty, for he have any power, every power, correct?
That's correct.
So he do not need a girlfriend. He can say B is going to be. That's simple. That's even what the Quran says in different place. If Allah wants something to be, he says B is going to be, correct?
That's correct.
Okay, so what is this excuse here? What does having a girlfriend have to do? We are talking about Allah. We are talking about a man. This is an answer can be good for me and you. I am single. You ask me why you don't have a child. I say, well, how am I going to have a child if I don't have a wife or girlfriend? That makes sense. But that does not make sense to God.
You're right.
So what we will do, my friend Muhammad?
Well, I have no answer to you.
Okay. Well, I appreciate your honesty. What about Allah? What about Allah saying he will have sex with himself?
Show me.
Okay, give me a second. Allah said that if Allah wants to have a wife, a partner, he will have it within ourselves.
This is Allah speaking.
Yes, Allah is speaking.
Show me your proof.
Okay, no problem. Give me a second. Can you want the translation from the same Shakir?
Sorry?
Do you want the same translator?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Here we go. This is the translation of Shakir. And let me show you that this is Shakir. Look at this, be sure first. Because sometime it might change. No, this is Yusuf Ali actually. Let me go to Shakir. Here we go. Shakir. Let me show you on the screen. Shakir. We click apply. All right. Here we go. We have Shakir. All right. Had we wished to make a diversion, we would have made it from ourselves.
Had we wished to make a diversion, we would.
What diversion mean? Do you know what diversion mean?
We had made it from before ourselves. Hmm. And that means, would we do it? What does it mean by we? Had we wished to make diversion, what does that mean?
Well, this is a translation. The fact it does not say diversion, it says the word in Arabic. Lahu, do you speak Arabic?
No, man.
Okay, lahu in Arabic. Lahu mean fun, but in the old language of the Arab, lahu is a woman who is for sex, for fun. So if you go to the front translator, just to show you, you know, we will go back to the translation you like because you choose this one. If you go to the front translator as an example, let us see Hilali and Khan. You will see Hilal and Khan says, had we intended to take a pastime, i.e. a wife or a son, etc., we could surely have taken it from ourselves, but we don't have, you know, we don't have a plan to do so. Okay. Allah want to take a wife. Allah want
to
take.
Had we intended to take pastime, a wife, a son, we could surely have taken it from us. If we are going to do that, what translation is this?
This is Hilali and Khan.
Okay.
Okay. If we go, do you like to see the interpretation?
Yeah, please.
Okay. You are a Sunni or Shia?
Sunni.
All right, that's wonderful. Oh, this is a Jalalain.
Oh, I'm a sect of Sunni, which is Wahhabi.
That's wonderful. So this is Tafsir al-Jalalain saying, had we desired to find some diversion, that which provide diversion in the way of partner or a child, we would have found it with ourselves. Who is ourselves? Allah is one, correct?
That's correct.
So how Allah want to take a partner, which is a woman, from ourselves?
Had we desired to find some division that was division in the way of partner or a child, we would have found it with ourselves from among the beautiful eyed houris or angels where we used to. So, but we did not do so, thus we never desired. We would have found it with ourselves.
Allah is one, but yet he says he would have sex with ourselves, because here talking about having a partner for sex. And it says even there in the front of your eyes, from what? From the beautiful eyed houris. The houris are a human female, correct?
Well, I have no answer to this.
Okay, so what do you do now, my friend? You are a Muslim, you are a Wahhabi, you are a Sunni, you are the one who will join Mujahideen one day to get the 70 versions, but as you see, Allah is sleeping with them already. And how Allah is saying, how Allah he says ourselves, we are the Muslims, why Allah he says we? They say this is a majestic statement because he is like a king. Okay, no problem, we will let it go. But here, he cannot. We cannot play this game. He will take a partner from ourselves, so it cannot be him, right?
That's correct.
Okay, so who is the ourself, and why? How God can take a partner? She is a woman. She is a whore. A houri is just a woman. She is very white to the point you can see through the marrow of their bones. So how the partner of Allah in the bed? She is a female woman. This is the only way to believe in this is if Allah Himself is a man.
That's correct. You're actually right. Okay, I find that very disturbing, and to be honest, I've never ever read this verse.
My friend, this is why Muslims, they always, they call me, they say, we never heard this before. But as you see, I'm showing on the screen everything I say, right? This is the official, this is the official government of the Kingdom of Jordan. Read with me. The official government of Jordan, Royal of Ahlul Bayt Institute, Islamic taught on Amman. This is Sunni, and this is a Jalalain, and this is official, and this is your Quran, and this is a Jalalain.
What website is this?
I just told you, this is at tafsir.com.
Tafsir.
At tafsir.com. At tafsir.com. At tafsir.
Wallah, I have no answer to you. You've proven me wrong, so what can I say to you?
Well, I don't know. I think you are in your way to leave Islam, because this is crazy. Allah is one, yet he want to take a partner. She is a female woman in order to sleep with a woman. My friend, with my respect to you. Okay, istaghfar Allah. Istaghfar as much as you want, but you cannot answer. As you see here, in order for God to sleep with the women, you have to have what? You have to have a private part of a male. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Because the women, she have a vagina, she don't have she is a woman. Okay, God, his name is Allah. Women, her name is the Huris, which means she is very white. And now he is saying, if I want to take it from ourself. The second I say ourself, it's mean me and her, we are from the same kind. If I go to your home now, right, with my respect, yeah, to your family, and I say to you, who is with you? He says, just us. What do you mean? You mean you and your family, right? Us. You don't say
exactly.
You don't say us about a stranger, the neighbor. He don't belong to you. He have nothing to do to you. So you say us. I mean, maybe your wife, your children's. Huh? Okay, that's us. Okay, us. Us here is who? Ourself. And then we find that ourself is women.
You're right. You're actually right. Mm. That makes sense when you say it.
So how Allah can be God?
I have to ask my sheikh.
Can your sheikh call me? Can you ask him to? Can you challenge him to call me?
This is the only Skype account you have.
Sorry.
This is the only Skype you have account.
We do not need 10 account. One account is enough. Right.
Even Australia, I don't know what time it is there.
No problem. If you agree to debate me, we can set up a time which is fit for me and him. No problem.
Okay, what time is it now?
I am always live on air, actually. You know, every day almost I go. Right now,
so you're always live? You always live on Skype?
No, not in Skype. When I go live on air, my Skype go on air too. So you want to call me, you go and see in YouTube. And then you tell me, okay, my sheikh is here. When I call you, he's welcome. All right? But anytime he can
okay,
call
no.
me.
Yeah. Okay, no problem, because I can't answer you, because you seem your own point.
Okay.
And
well, Muhammad, let me then you know, I don't want to ask you questions. I want you to tell me, forget about me, you know, try showing you things which is really crazy about Muhammad and his book. What about you? Show me something is good about Islam, or something can convince us, or what is convincing you that Muhammad is a prophet?
If you read in the Quran, it says whoever kills one person has killed the whole mankind. So that's showing that Islam is peace.
That's not really what it says. The Quran.
Prove it.
The Quran speak that this is an order Allah he gave to the Jews, not to you.
Prove it.
Oh, here we go. Chapter 5, verse number 35. You read it for me.
Okay. For this did we prescribe to the children of Israel, and whoever slays a soul, unless it will be for manslaughter of his mischief in the land, it is as though he slew all men, and whoever keeps it alive, it is as though he kept alive all men. Essentially, our apostles came to them with clear arguments, but even after that, many of them certainly act exactly in the land.
So is that for Israel, my friend, or this is for Muslims?
or doesn't, wait, for the reason we did not describe before as well. Yeah, but you gotta read the verses before.
No problem, you can read 10 verses. The Quran is have nothing to do with each other. Quran is not connected, really. You know, yeah, read it. This is about Allah speaking about what He gave the Jews. He told the people of Israel. Do you see the word Israel? This is the first, yes, same verse you quote for me. Okay, so then, this is okay. The verse after it, look with this. So, how the one who kills someone, a soul, as if he killed all mankind, and the verse after it says, the punishment for those who waged war against Allah and His apostle,
His apostles,
to cut their hands, to cut their feet, to crucify them. Okay, what is the war mean? Right now, I'm doing war against Allah. So, according to the Quran, now I am a criminal. I should be killed. I should be crucified. So, how He says to us, the Quran says in chapter 5, verse number 32. The one who kills someone is innocent, as if he killed all mankind. And the same Quran saying, anyone who wage war against Allah, you know, cut his hands, torture him, not only kill him. This is torture. This is a horror movie. Why you want to cut hands of people and why you want to crucify them? Kill them. Let's say if somebody is a criminal, okay, kill him. Why you want to torture?
The punishment of those who wage war against Allah and His apostle who strives to make mischief in the land is only His. This they should be murdered or crucified, or their hands and their feet be cut off on opposite sides, or they should be imprisoned. They shall be disgraced for them in this world, and hereafter they shall have grief, chastisement.
Does it say in the translation, if you see in front of you, of your choice, does it say they should be murdered?
It does.
Okay, what does murder mean? Murder is killing somebody. Is a victim.
That's correct.
Okay, so what? So how the verse before it says, "Don't kill somebody innocent," and then the verse after it says,
you gotta look into the history for this verse. Like,
my friend, no problem. Trust me, I know all the history. But it says, "Murder them." I mean, why even, it says murder?
Even in the Old Testament, it says, it says murder innocent people, doesn't it?
Where?
In the Old Testament.
Well, Muhammad here is trying, Muhammad in verse number 32, he's trying to copy from the Old Testament. It's from the Old Testament where it says don't murder innocent people. So Muhammad trying prove to copy. Then. Okay, we can show you, but here Muhammad is trying to prove everything Muhammad he come with is coming from somewhere. Everything. Not a single story in the Quran is the story of Muhammad. Let me ask you, have you ever heard of Alexander the Great?
Yes.
Okay, is he a Muslim?
Yes.
But Alexander the Great is a homosexual and he is a bisexual. How he can be a Muslim prophet?
You're saying all this, why don't you prove it?
You can go right now, search in Google, they will see that he was a bisexual. You sleep with men and women and they sleep with him too, you know. secondly, when you say you are laughing, why you are laughing?
Because it's foolish what you're saying.
Really, it's foolish. Why isn't it foolish because to believe Alexander the Great, who is a pagan, that he's a prophet of Allah? How he can be a prophet of Allah? He's a pagan.
Yeah, but the greatest and best role model of people is Muhammad, not Alexander the Great.
I don't understand. Say again, what?
Yeah, but we don't care about Alexander the Great. We care about Muhammad.
No, it doesn't matter. You care about who? You care about what Allah said. Don't you care about the word of Allah?
Of course I do.
Okay, if the word of Allah is silly, it's mean Allah cannot be God. Look what Allah, He said about Alexander the Great, the one you claim and you agree that he is a prophet in Islam. He said that he found the sun sitting in murky water. Do you believe that the sun set in murky water, or you believe that the sun set in the microwave?
No, it meant like the sun, when they said the sun rested in the murky water, it doesn't mean literally rested in the murky water. It was like,
no, it means that. It means that. You see, the Muslim here, They give false translation. It says he found it going down into a black sea. There's nowhere it says black sea. It says a spring of murky water. We change the translation. Look how Muslims always they fabricate. I don't know what to say. I mean, there is no honest translation. Okay, here we go. We go to Yusuf Ali. Look what happened.
Oh.
Until when he reached the setting of the sun, he found it set in a spring of a murky water. Does it say that?
Until when he reached the setting of the sun, he found it in the spring of murky water. Near he found the people. He said, "Oh, Zul Quran possesses authority either to punish him or to treat them with kindness."
Do you believe it?
If you look at this translation in old Arabic, murky water means black sea.
No, in Arabic there's no black sea. Here we go. Let me read it for you in Arabic, my friend. Arabic is my language. I am not from China. حتى إذا بلغ مغرب الشمس وجدها تغرب في عين حمية. As simple as that. And this is the translation. It says,
What type of Arabic are you?
What?
What type of Middle Eastern are you?
I understand what? Middle Eastern?
Are you a Shori?
No, I am an
Egyptian.
Arab. No, I am not an Egyptian. I am an Arab.
What type of Arab?
The kind.
Because every Arab has a different translation.
The kind who take a shower once a year. I mean, who care? I don't take a shower once a year. I think next week I have my annual shower. What does this have to do with my topic, my friend? Now, if I go and I give interpretation that the sun set in murky water, do you think that will be a foolish from me to say such a thing?
I'm not gonna lie, it is.
Huh?
I'm not gonna lie, it is kind of funny to say that.
No, I'm not saying Allah, I'm not Allah saying that. Let's say I am the one giving interpretation. I understood it in such a way. Is that will make me foolish to understand it in such a way that the sun really set in murky water?
It is foolish.
Okay, it's foolish. Okay, guys, did he say it's foolish? Muhammad, he said it's foolish. So if a Christian prince, he say that this is what it says, and this is his understanding, this is a foolish understanding. Do we agree with that, Muhammad?
I shouldn't be saying this, but I do agree.
Yeah, so you are saying if I say that, okay, I am foolish. Okay, what if I show you that Muhammad is the one who said that?
All right, show me then.
All right. You know, I expect from you to be a person who respect his words as a man, and everybody heard you saying that this is a foolish. So if Muhammad says that, then you have to be brave and stand with your words. You cannot take it back.
If you can prove it, I'll take my words.
Okay, here we go. Muhammad is the man. He will keep his word. Be with witness, guys. This is the hadith. Read with me carefully.
How can you read from hadith? Hadith don't mean nothing, they're weak.
Who said it's weak? How you know it's weak? Hold on. First of all, you said to me, you will keep your words if I show you Muhammad, he said that. Now, right away, before even you read the hadith, even before you read the hadith, you come and say, it is weak. Did you even know the hadith? Do you know even which book? You don't know. But this is a defense system from the Muslims. Right away, anything we show them, we say it's weak. No, it's not weak. Here we go. Let us click at the hadith and see. Read with me carefully. Read carefully with me. Does it say weak? Oh, it says sahih.
What is that sahih? I can't see it.
Now, do you see it?
Yeah, I can see it here.
Okay, so it's sahih. Now we go to the hadith. I was sitting behind the Messenger of Allah. You read it for us. Your English is better than mine. Go ahead.
I can't see it.
Why you cannot see it?
Oh, now I can see it. I was sitting behind the Messenger of Allah, who was riding a donkey while the sun was setting. He asked, "Do you know where this sets?" I replied, "Allah and His Apostle know best." He said, "It sets in a spring of warm water, Hamiyath."
So
what the hell
you said? What the hell? I agree with you. What the hell, guys? Did you hear it? What the hell? What Muhammad is talking about? You said anyone who says that is foolish. Are you willing to say it again? Be a man, and you promise you will not take it back.
I shouldn't be saying it, but it does sound foolish.
It sounds foolish. I agree with you. Thank you, Muhammad. So Muhammad, he say foolish things, and he claimed, and this is in total agreement with the Quran. So there's no way Muhammad is a prophet of God, yet he don't understand what Allah he gave him. Who can understand the Quran better? You, me, or Muhammad? For sure Muhammad, correct?
Right.
Okay, so Muhammad, he understand the Quran, and he's explained us the verse. The sun set in the murky water, exactly as it says in the Quran. So how Muhammad can be a prophet of God saying foolish stuff?
I don't know what to say to you.
Well, you should leave Islam, my friend. You're a man of
your words. It's
not that easy. When it's easy, you just say this is foolish. Are you going to follow something foolish? With my respect to you.
It's not hard, like it's hard, you know, going up with the
my friend. It's hard. I understand it's hard, but are we going to follow something foolish just because it's hard? I mean, that would make it more foolish. With my respect to you again.
Do you agree? No, I agree what you're saying.
Okay,
but
because it's hard, I will decide to stay and follow something foolish, and that will make it foolish. That will make it more foolish.
Before I do it, but I want to get my sheikh to call you.
But you just said this is foolish. You are out of Islam already. You just insulted Muhammad. You just said Muhammad is saying foolish things, which means he's a foolish man, and he's a liar in the top of that. Because it's a foolish to lie. It's a foolish to lie about God. And it's a big foolish to think you can fool people claiming that God told you. So Muhammad here is not only making a statement foolish, because we can say stupid things, all of us, but he claimed that he's speaking in the name of God. He claimed that he's a prophet of God. He claimed that what he is telling us is godly words and godly knowledge. So now when he speak, he speak in the name of the God which he sent him. So speaking foolishness is an insult to Allah, insult to you, insult to every one of us, because this man is trying to fool us, make us believe that he's a prophet.
You're right. So I'm disagreeing with you, but
you cannot disagree with me. So you have to leave Islam now. You just said you cannot disagree with me. You cannot disagree with me. I heard you. Okay. Why you don't leave Islam? Say I am out of Islam. You are a smart man. You will not accept, and you have an honor. I can tell you kept your words. There's many, they don't keep their words. They are potatoes. You are a man. So how a man like you, brave man like you,
it's easy for you to say.
No, it's not easy, my friend. I deal with Muslims every day. I'm not going to follow anything foolish. I'm not a fool. I'm not stupid. It's an insult to me. It's an insult to you. It's an insult to you to respect yourself, and yet you are going to pray in the morning to someone who is foolish.
I'm getting goosebumps.
Sorry?
I'm getting goosebumps.
You're getting what?
Goosebumps.
I'm not sure what does that mean.
What do I say?
You should leave Islam. Say, I am out of Islam, my friend. I am out of foolishness. That's not for you. You are smarter than this. Just say it.
I don't know, man.
Why you don't know? You know, you just said Muhammad is a foolish man. You just said that. You know, if you say you are out of Islam or not yet, you just already did. Say it. I am out of the cult of Islam. It's obvious that this is a cult.
Oh, you mean out of... I'm out of the cult of Islam.
That's wonderful. Hallelujah. We are so happy for you. You are a smart man. You made a good decision. You call me as a Wahhabi Muslim, and now you are out of the cult of Islam. What do you want more? It's a good day for you, my friend. This is a wonderful day for you. So all your life you spend worshipping false God, false prophet, following false teaching, making fun of us. And look, it took us not long, and you discovered that everything they taught you, it was a lie. Now, my friend, what do you think about Christianity? As long as you left Islam, I am a Christian, as you know. What do you think about what do you think about following Christ?
So because I left, so if I die today, would I go heaven or hell?
No, today you are going no heaven, no hell yet, because simply still you are alive and you are breathing, and God will let you have your chance to the last moment in your life to make a decision. And this is why I'm asking you, because I would love to help you. I helped you to leave the cult of Islam, but now I would love to help you to go to heaven, as I believe, which is believing in the Messiah. That? Okay, you believe in the Messiah. The Messiah is the only one who can save you. Not me, no one, no prophet, no prophet, no priest, no bishop, no sheikh, nobody. The only one who can save you is the Messiah. You accept him, you give your heart to him, you promise to obey him, to be a decent man. You don't, you know, the 10th commandment is there. Don't kill, don't lie, don't steal, don't commit adultery. Don't. But the most important thing is to be a person who loves the world, to be a loving person like the Messiah. And the second you say, the second you practice one sentence of Jesus Christ's teaching, which is that if a person, he love the one who is his enemy, then we have no enemy left. And then you will know the wisdom of God. Love your enemy, bless those who curse you. So you forget about everything you learned as a Muslim, cursing people, cursing Christians, cursing Jews, cursing the Shia, cursing the atheist, all of this madness, it's hateful. You dump it in the back and you love even your enemy. And then you will see inside you will be a different person. And here you notice right away that this is must be a teaching from the true God, not God who teach hate, spread hate between people. Love your enemy, pray for those who curse you. So if you practice one sentence of Christ, the whole, actually, imagine Muhammad, if me and you and everybody in this earth practice just one sentence, not the whole Bible, just one sentence Jesus said, love your enemy. Do you think we will need an army? Nobody will need
you. Right.
Nobody will need the police, and nobody will be hungry, and nobody will be homeless, and nobody will be killed, and no woman will be raped, and no weak person will be assaulted or take advantage of her, because all of us, we love everybody, then everybody help everybody. It's a perfect community. It's heaven and earth. So following Jesus bring heaven to this earth, even though this earth is not heaven. So why you don't want to follow Jesus?
You explained it very good. What I was taught was different.
They lie to you, my friend. They lie to you. And here we are truthful people.
It's not going to be easy for me, but I guess it's worth it.
Well, it's not about easy. It's about following the truth. It's not only about worth it. It is the truth. You see, it's not about worth it. This is not about a value. This is not about a great teaching. This is about following the truth. We are not following a philosopher who speaks philosophy. We are following God who teach the truth, and the truth will set you free. So I'm not asking you to believe in Jesus, to believe in a person who speaks good. No. We are following a person who no one speaks like him. No one, and his wisdom is beyond imagination, and the beauty of his wisdom is beyond beauty, and the truth of his wisdom is the solution for all our problems in this earth. And that's why, my friend, I'm asking you to believe in him and to accept him today, tonight, before you go to bed, so you can feel comfortable and you will not be worried about going to hell.
I accept him.
I mean to that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, my friend. Praise be to the Lord, our friend Muhammad. It's amazing that 3 days we have and the 3 Muhammad left Islam. You believe it? 3 Muhammad left Islam, and you are number 3 in the last, what, 48 hours or maybe 3 days. So, my friend Muhammad, I'm really so happy for you. And as you see, this is Matthew chapter 5, verse number 44. But I say to you, love your enemies, bless those who curse you, do good to those who hate you. Have you ever heard of somebody saying do good to those who hate you?
No, never.
And pray for those who persecute you, hurt you. I mean, imagine. I mean, what is left? What, where we can go farther? How noble he is. And this is the best way to overcome your anger and your hate. And hate is the first enemy for us. Hate kill me before it kill my enemy. There's many people die because of their hate, because of their jealousy, because of their anger. Hate will kill you. Hate is a poison inside your heart.
Yeah, you're right. I'm not gonna lie. It is a disgusting emotion to express towards someone.
And here we notice the difference, and the huge difference between the words of Muhammad and the words of the Messiah. Muhammad, he speaks foolishness, stupidity, and the Messiah, he provides us with amazing, beautiful wisdom, can help us in everything. Who need, what kind of God he wanna give me women and 72 women, and that will give me in this private part? What is that? I mean, this is crazy, and this is even not respectful for God.
So
Muhammad, I want you to do me a favor, my friend. I want you, the Bible is, you live in Australia, correct?
Yeah.
The Bible is available for free everywhere, and you can read it even in the internet. We have the free, the four gospels, and four gospels mean four witnesses. Doesn't mean that they are not gospel, just four witnesses. Four witnesses for the message and the teaching of Christ. I advise you to read it from your heart, and always when you read the gospel, try to live it, not just to read it. There's people who read with their eyes, but their heart is not there. So I would like you to try your best to read the gospel and to live the gospel, which means imagine yourself there, like, you know, we're talking about the Messiah speaking to a crowd. You can play audio. There's a website, they have audio for the gospel, so you can relax and the person is reading the gospel for you. Imagine yourself there and live the words of God, and the word of God will guide you, and the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, will be with you, my friend. From today, you are a child of God. You are not a slave of Allah. You know how we Christian, you know how we Christian we pray, right? You heard us saying, our Father art of heaven, not anything. Our Father. Do you know what our Father mean?
Like
our Father.
Like a father.
Like a father. That's wonderful. So you in Islam, you were a slave. You now in Christianity, you are a child of God. This is how much he loves you. A child of God who is belong to his Father, not a slave. Yes, at the end of the day, you know, he can enslave us. He can destroy us. He can do whatever he wants with us. But because he is a loving God, we are his children. He gave us the honor to call him God, our Father. This is how loving he is. So the God we worship is totally far by nature, by ethic, by teaching, by everything from the false God of Muhammad.
Amen.
Happy for you, my friend Muhammad, and I'm happy for you to be today to accept the Messiah and to leave Islam. And feel free, please, to call me anytime you wish. And don't forget to tell your Sheikh to call me if he dare.
Okay, but pray for me, okay?
We will. All the Christians here, we have, like today, we are not busy too much because I'm going late here in USA. We have only like 800. All the Christians here, trust me, they are praying from their heart for you and even your family. And even those who will not like to hear the news that you left Islam and you became a Christian today.
Amen, brother.
All right, my friend. Good to see you.
And thank you so much for answering.
God bless. Take care, my friend. Take care, Muhammad.
You too. Bye-bye.
Please, guys, everybody, pray for our brother Muhammad. And by the way, don't change your name. Keep your name Muhammad and witness to Jesus as Muhammad. Don't call yourself James. Don't call yourself Thomas. Don't call yourself David. You are as your name is. Would be wonderful to have a Muhammad witnessing to Jesus the Christ as his God and his Savior. Keep your name, my friend. And in the last 3 days, we have three Muhammad left Islam. That's wonderful, is it? So And by the way, not all those who leave Islam talking to me, they come on air. There's many of them. That's why I'm losing my voice, because I'm not talking only in air. I, you know, people, they ask me to speak in private because they don't want to be exposing themselves. And this is why my voice is really hurting me. And that's why I said, you know, I want to take 2 days off, because I'm getting headache from talking too much. I'm not talking only the YouTube I do. This is not really the problem. It's after that, you know, like, you know, it's endless. But still, I cannot resist. I cannot resist to do what need to be done. And here we go. Thank you, Lord. If no, if not a Muslim, he post a link in my channel about that video, I will not be going live on air. So look what happened. A Muslim wanted to supposedly refute us, made me come here. And when I came here, we got this gentleman, Muhammad, calling me to prove me wrong. He called me as a Muslim Sunni Wahhabi, and he left as a Christian who believe in the Messiah, the Christ, as his Lord. Isn't it God is wonderful? But please pray for this gentleman and his family. His Muslim family, pray for them. His Muslim family, they need your prayer too. So they will accept him, and they will be loving people, and they will remember that this is their son, who he loved them. And my friend, love your family. Don't do what the Muslims do. Quran chapter 9 verse number 23, it says you cannot take even your father and your brother as a friend. Don't do that. You are a Christian now. Don't do that. You are a Christian, and you have a duty to love your family, to love everybody. And your family are the first to start with.